Before we begin this episode, yes, I do have a message. We have the brand new True Podcast Reddit. It actually has been around for a while, but we are officially using the True Podcast Reddit for the place for True Mailbag questions and really anything. So go ahead, send your fan art, as some have already. Send us questions there and talk about whatever. And hey, maybe you'll get some exclusive Trio merch sales over there. So go join the Trio Reddit, link in the description, and enjoy the episode. From Anchor, the Trio Podcast starring Bubble and Curbs. This is Who's Bubble alongside Mr. Curbs and the Trio Orchestra, inviting you to join the trio, and special guest Sue Young, also known as Camila. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a trio! Hello everyone, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Trio Podcast alongside Mr. Curbs and special guest, Sue Young.
Hello.
I'm your host, Who's Bubble.
I'm so sorry.
Thanks for checking in. Welcome to episode 38. It's a pleasure to be here, yep. Hello, how are we doing?
You're asking me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm good. Tired. I'm alright.
How about you, Curbs?
Yeah, I'm doing fine.
Alright, everybody's doing okay. It's good to hear. So yeah, we're here with special guest Sue. I'll just call you Sue. Professional K-pop star.
Oof.
And Archer. So, yeah.
That's a pretty good resume.
That's a good resume right there. You know, I've never actually met a pro Archer before.
I wouldn't call myself a pro. I say that I do archery.
Oh my god.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. All right, well, welcome back, everybody. We're just going to start off. What are your hobbies? What is your passions? What, are you in school? Just talk about yourself for a little bit.
I'm 16. I work for a company called JYP Entertainment.
Shout out.
My passions are long walks on the beach and reading a book.
It's always good.
Mostly I do archery. I play video games. I dance a lot. I don't really sing. That's not my my strongest point.
Okay.
But you know, I try to make everyone laugh as much as I can because deep down I'm sad.
Oh, well, that's not good.
Yeah.
Hey, man,
it's spicy also, memory.
We're all a little sad. There's always those moments. I feel like the most sad I am is when I'm in school because I have to sit there and listen to people talk.
Yeah.
Just like
well, that's not, a not point, bro.
Fuck the system. That's stupid. I don't know why I said that. Alright. That was stupid. But
wait, so would you consider yourself a better dancer, archer, or singer?
I consider myself a better dancer, if anything. Like, I'm very agile.
What type of dancing do you do?
Oof.
Is there different...
When I was younger, I used to do ballet. Like, when I was 4 to, like, 13. Wow. Then, I stopped doing that and decided to pursue more, like, upbeat, like, either breakdancing, hip-hop, interpretive, stuff like that.
That's sick. Would you say, wait, what?
Like, it's all right. It's not sick. It's
just you think that. The archery's more sick, or
I think so. Like, not a lot of people do archery, but I suck at archery.
Yeah, my good friend Shompy Banana, shout out. He does some archery, so shout out to him.
Yeah, I mean, I like the TV show Green Arrow, so.
Nice.
Oh, it's a good one, Curbs. Never heard of that show, actually, but.
There's no way you've ever heard of that show. That's actually.
I saw, you know, that only time. Okay, never mind. I'm going to forget about that.
Yeah, let's forget about Green Arrow.
So, have you ever participated in any archery tournaments? If so, how did that go?
I did. I was in Korea. I was with a whole bunch of idols. You know, we were doing, like, little games and stuff. And, yeah, I did archery. It was pretty fun. I missed the bullseye, but it was fun.
Oh, you didn't get a bullseye?
No, I was close to it, but no. Oh. I think it was like a pity point. So
how does that work? Yeah. Do you got like the most points wins or something?
Yeah, so basically the bullseye is 10 points. You get 3 arrows. Depending on how far it is. So if it's like 25 yards, then the point system will be a little bit more, like, let's say 25 for a bullseye.
Right.
And whoever gets the highest score, like, proceeds.
Okay.
So,
have you ever won one of those?
Archery?
Yeah.
No, I lost. I lost first round.
Has there only been one tournament?
Yeah, only one tournament, but it was just like a big arena.
In Korea.
It kind of felt like, in Korea.
That's crazy.
In Korea? Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever, like, shot an apple off someone's head?
First of all, I did not make a bullseye.
Oh, so
you really want
danger? That would probably be a bit dangerous.
You really want me to try that?
Yeah, maybe be best for the person.
All right. You be the person to hold the apple. All right.
Yeah, put an apple on your head, Curbs.
I trust you.
All right. Thank you for the trust.
Put a bulletproof vest on, though.
Yeah. And headgear.
Yeah, that might be.
Speaking Make sure of you like run away when I shoot the arrow. All right.
I fall off my head.
It's fine.
So, do you have any special gear for archery, like a bow and like arm guards or something?
For me, like they gave me an arm guard. They gave me gloves. They gave me a bow. They gave me a hunter's bow. That's more precise. That's more like, you don't have to like angle yourself to go further.
There's like, different types, like compound bows.
Yeah, there's like a long bow, hunter's bow, range bow. There's a lot.
Yeah, shout out to anybody who was in my gym class last year. They know, you know, I'm a pro at archery actually. You know, I watched the archery Olympics and I studied that for a while.
Oh, why didn't you introduce yourself?
I just don't play, that's why.
I
just play tennis. If
anybody Wait, what made you get into archery? Because that's like interesting, like kind of, it's not like it's unique.
What got me into archery, I don't know, I just felt like, oh, I've seen Brave, so I can do it.
That was a pretty good movie.
Yeah.
It's a classic.
That was my analogy. Like, if I saw a movie and they did it with ease, I can do it.
Right. All right, so now it's time to move on. We're going to talk about your K-pop group. So, why don't you talk about it?
So, I debuted, like, 2 weeks ago.
Oh, damn.
It was for JYP. He went Things for America. The auditions was in California. So I was like, you know what? Like, my friend wanted to do it, and I was like, sure, why not? I'll support. And she failed miserably. Then he came, and he was like, oh, it's okay. Like, he consoled her because she was, like, a mess.
Right.
And then I came, and I was like, hi. And then he asked me to audition, and I was like, all right, yes. And my audition, I didn't know what to do. Like, I didn't know any K-pop.
And now you're
you made it without doing any, without knowing any K-pop.
Yeah. I was like, do you know Korean? I was like, yeah. And he was like, oh, okay, that's easier to like sing in Korean. I was like, I guess. I auditioned, I got in, I was surprised.
You could go on.
I'm sorry. Continue.
Yeah, so you speak in Korean for your songs?
For our debut song, no. Everyone is American. So he just told us to sing in English for our debut.
Right.
Pretty fun.
Wait, so you don't speak in Korean at all then for that?
You said this was for JYP? This looks like a pretty big company.
It is.
Damn. It's impressive.
So what's the name of your group again?
Vitra.
Alright guys, shout out to Vitra. We'll leave that link in the description. Whatever you want, we'll leave the link in the description. So go check
it
out.
Wait, Vitra?
Yeah.
I just googled JYP. It says JYP's new girl group, Vicha, number one on US Billboard.
Oh.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Wait. Hold up. You might be the most popular person we've had on this podcast. Wait. There's no way.
I thought you were an archer, man.
Bro, you went looking for, like, an archer, and you found, like, gold. Wait, hold up.
Wait, is it
called YO Universe?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. It's number one.
Yo, that is...
Damn, congratulations.
Thank you.
It's amazing, bro. Wow. Alright, well, shout out to them. I mean, I don't even think they need a shout out, but, yeah. Yeah, so you have, how many songs have you done in total with them?
We did four, and they're out now, like, on Spotify.
Right.
But we still have our song, like a pre-debut song is called C-Beat.
Okay.
But we're still making new songs, but they're not going to come out anytime soon. Probably, like, when we get a little bit more fans. We'll release some more for mini albums, but
wow, I've never experienced this mid podcast. We've totally shifted the gear from Archer.
I googled it, and all of a sudden I saw like Vicha, and it was like number one on the Billboard. I'm like flabbergasted.
Yeah, I was like literally on TV.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Wait, you were in the YO Universe song?
Yeah. Well, obviously, we have to use, like, English names.
Are you lying?
No, that's it.
Are you, which one are you? Are you Camila, Lexi, Kendall,
No,
Savannah?
Soo Young, man.
No,
that's my Korean name. Yeah, we have to use English.
Right.
My name is Camila.
Camila, alright.
The tallest one from the group.
That's nice.
We love tall people here.
I know.
So you just like auditioned without knowing any K-pop, and now you got signed to like a major label and like are number one on the charts?
Yeah.
Damn.
Oh my god, bro. Hey man, this was a rush podcast, but I think this.
You said you weren't a star earlier.
I'm not.
Oh man,
I feel like that's kind of like star territory, like borderline star.
Hey, hey man, I consider myself a star, man.
What?
I consider Mr. Curbs a star, like.
All right. Well.
And you don't even consider yourself one? That is crazy.
No.
Okay.
Man, that's a pretty proud accomplishment.
Well, I guess should we keep calling you Soo Young or?
No, just keep saying Soo Young. We don't need to say Camila.
Okay.
So I don't even know what to talk about next. I forgot. Like, that was a shocker.
Wait, you said you were 16?
That's what I tell people I am.
But you're not, right?
I'm 18.
Okay. I was just doing a background check real quick.
I'm 18.
That's crazy.
2005, maybe.
Damn, already number one on the Billboard at 18.
Wait, so if you were, then what college did you go to?
What? Mm-hmm.
If you were the legit, then what college did you go to?
you're quizzing her?
Why are you quizzing me?
I don't know,
man. Don't believe her. You don't believe her. She's why Vicha.
Hey, man, I don't know, man. It's... I thought it was an archer.
It doesn't say archery.
Anyway, let's get back to this, bro. Alright, so you're in this band, right? You said they're in California though, what'd you say?
We did auditions in California.
Okay. And now what? Are you like touring or something?
No, I'm in Korea.
Oh, so they all went to Korea?
Yeah. Wow. That's where the headquarters is. So.
Right. So, when is the next song coming out? We all want to know.
I can't tell
you that. Yo, this was like 6 days ago, and it's 15 trending on music.
I can tell you that more songs are coming, but I can't tell you when.
Well, Curbs, we do have some trio mailbag questions.
You've got mail.
Trio mailbag, all right.
We have some questions. You guys could all answer these questions, okay? These are honest questions here. All right, so we got some questions. First question is, what's your favorite school subject and why? Curbs?
Why would somebody ask me that? I don't know. Science, I guess. It's useful, maybe.
Science is wild.
Science is wild? I don't know. Fine. History. It's easy.
I'm not you changing your favorite subject.
Why are you changing your
subject? I don't like school. Okay. I don't really give a shit about the favorite subject.
You changing your subject more times. You changing your underwear.
What?
All right. I'm gonna have to go with, history because everybody loves history, guys.
And you're failing every other subject.
Okay, we don't talk about that.
No, not putting on the spot.
What about you, Sue? That rhymed.
I like English. Like I like reading. I like grammar, stuff like that.
Nope.
So,
I don't really like essays.
Big fan of essays. Love writing them.
So sarcastic.
Anyway.
All right. What else?
Next question is from Matthew Long. What's your address? Okay.
Let's skip that one.
Let's skip that one. What are your goals for 2024, Cribs?
For the Trio podcast to sell more than one T-shirt.
Yeah.
You know what? If you guys send me a shirt, I'll wear it.
Alright, where in the next... Wait, would you wear it in, like, a music video?
I wouldn't wear it in a music video, but I would wear it in a live. Like, if I go live.
Alright, you know what? Michael, this might be... We might want to look into this.
Okay, we'll be sending you a shirt.
If you know my address. But, I can't... I'll give you, like, information for, like,
Matthew Long has asked, what's your address? So, I guess that...
Alright, well, we don't
listen. I can't say that. Stalkers.
Yeah, we can't say it on a live.
Okay. Anyway, next question. Okay, my goals for 2024 is to, you know what? Reach 1,000 followers on Spotify. There you go. Yeah. Not 1,000 streams, 1,000 followers. Yep.
Yeah.
I want to be as big as Soo Young one day. That's my goal.
Hey, yo.
And what about you?
I'll be able to make more songs and actually do like a solo kind of music video. But as for now, for like my mentality now, it's more like I hope I'll still be healthy. When I'm like going out on stage and stuff like that.
Yeah, we need to all work on our health. It's important. Especially mental health.
Yeah.
Damn. So, the next question is, why doesn't Bubble show his face on podcast since he did a face reveal? That's a good question. And that's because it would look weird with just one person's face.
Yeah.
Yeah. Curbs, if you show your face, then I'll show mine there. That's
don't pressure me into showing my face, bud.
So comment down below if you want to see that happen. And yeah, that's the questions for the trio mailbag today.
All right.
Yeah. Wait. So let's get back to here. I want to know how many music videos have you done?
I think only one, right?
Yeah, only one. It's not for nothing. It's kind of hard doing a music video.
Yeah.
Dude, I can imagine.
Because
six days ago.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Wait, which one is it? Which song?
It's called YO Universe Feature. It's trending.
Oh, that's
on
number
music.
One, bro. That's number one. I've heard that. Yeah. That's classic.
What?
Have you really?
Hey, man, that's got over millions streams so far.
It's got over 5 million views right now.
Yeah.
Is any of the other members, like, were they already known, or is they all up and coming?
No, everyone, like, literally everyone's, like, straight out of high school.
Yeah, it said, was up and coming on the article that I was reading.
Somebody needs to sign Zach Gilbert, and somebody needs to sign Who's Bubble. That's what I heard.
Okay.
Is that what you heard?
Yeah, I heard that from somewhere.
Maybe she can put in a good word for you. You can get signed to JYP.
I'm going to Korea again.
No. Alright, I'll see you there.
Alright. Can you tell me a Korean word?
I'm Samiram.
What's that mean?
Thank you.
Alright, Samiram, joining us.
No, Kamsamida.
Kamsamida.
Yeah, Kamsamida.
That's close enough. Alright, Curbs, any other questions? I mean, we have one and only Soo Young here, so any other questions? I mean, here, I'm actually curious. For the music videos, there's specific outfits you have to wear, right?
Yeah, we each got a signature color.
Okay, that's cool. Sick.
It's like the, I don't know, Power Rangers. Oh.
Not like the Power Rangers.
Not like quiet. So,
but music videos, you get like a little headpiece, and they put it in your ear, so you can hear the song, so you know what is your part. But it's hard trying to like stay in rhythm, because like the song goes slow, but you have to dance fast, and it's.
So you're a good dancer too, because you've done ballet in the past. And you're pro.
Yeah.
So you're more fitted than the job than you think, I think.
I got in by chance.
Hey, man. Luck is on your side. But yeah, buy our merch. Link in the description. We have a brand new collection, guys. The Novelty Trio merch. One of the shirts says, I watched the Trio podcast and all I got was a t-shirt. Sounds pretty funny. Yeah, there's a bunch of good ones.
Someone actually bought that one. I was surprised.
You also have a Trio shot glass if you want to drink. Gator.
How much is that?
Of course.
Hold on, let me search you guys up. How much is that?
You know.
Everyone always complains about the price, but we put it at like the lowest we could. Wait, yeah. How much actually are they, Bubble?
You could probably get a t-shirt with shipping for like 20.
For 20 bucks?
Yeah, I would say it's worth it.
Let's see. Yeah, use one t-shirt's like 20 bucks. The shot glass is like $17.
Code curbs, 10% off, guys.
Honestly, like, I thought it was going to be a little bit more if you are doing a podcast.
Yeah.
Like, at least, like, 35.
Well, there you go, guys. We have a supporter right here. We hear you, Matthew Long, complaining, or whoever that was.
No, yesterday some guy was complaining, like, these shirts are too expensive.
What the hell? I think they're cheap. You want to know what's expensive? So, our music video, like, for those clothes, they cost more than $170. Just for, like, shoes alone.
Just for the shoes?
Yeah.
For each person? So that's $170 for everyone's shoes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well. And each person has, like, a different style, and it's, like, custom. It's not expensive.
So stop complaining about our merch, please.
Stop complaining about our merch.
Exactly.
$170 shoes.
Okay,
maybe
so
we can make the trio airs.
Alright, I gotta tell you something fairly interesting here. This is a Vodcha group ranking. Somebody ranked your members.
What?
I don't know why.
Wait, but didn't they just like debut like 6 days ago?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Camille is rank 3.
That's pretty good.
Out of 6, I think. So, is it 6?
Yeah.
That's right, pretty good. So you must have a talented voice then.
We don't talk about that.
Why don't we talk about that?
Not you putting me on the spot.
Hey man, I'm a singer myself, so I really think I'm bad too, but hey, we could auto-tune, you know. Guys, go listen to Stargazer, and Curbs, what do you have to say?
Is it the outro, or do I just say goodnight?
Have a blessed night. Any last words, Soo Young?
Thank you guys for finding me and making me be a part of this podcast episode. But I really had fun. Thank you again. I hope you come back one day. Probably not. But, you know, hope's still there. Yeah, just message me if you guys want me again.
When you make it big time.
Yeah.
Alright, Curbs, it looks. I think you're getting a phone call.
Dude, someone's fucking texting me, bro. You're so popular.
Wow. You got all those waiting for you.
Exactly.
Thank you guys for watching and have a blessed night.
Alright, bye.
Bye.